First, let's create an ellipse with ellipse tool, or the shortcut is E to create an ellipse. And I start to drag from here. Okay, click the object and press D to activate the eyedropper tool and change the color to this color. Or you can put this color code to here. And you can click twice to rotate it until you see this rotate icon. Alright, just drag it. Not too much. And you can scale it up by click the object and hold Ctrl Shift to create a proportional scale. Alright, next, add a text with text tool. Press T or you can click this icon and type some example brand name and change the font to. You can download the font on the link in the description. Alright, change the color to this white color. And you can scale it up by holding Ctrl Shift and place it on here. This time I drag to the top to make it skew. Next, I want to change the type of the letters, so you can see my previous video about how to use the character map on Inkscape and Windows. I put a link on description. So let's open the character map, and on Linux you choose the private use area and change the font name to same font, the milkshake. I want to change the L letter to this. So double click, click copy, block this L letter, and press Ctrl V to paste. Let me scale it down by clicking the text and hold Ctrl Shift. So it's in this ellipse. Turn off the enable snipping for now. You can move freely without that bounding box. Not all the fonts using these clips, I mean this variation of the letter, but in this milkshake font, it includes the clips. Next, add the shadow filter for the text, so click the text first, and go to filters, shadow and glow, choose the drop shadows. Turn on this live preview to see what happened. And you can change the inner to outer first. So it will create an outer drop shadow outside from this text. You can slightly increase the blur. Right, that's too much. I think around 2.2. And you can adjust the shadow position. Okay, then click apply, then close. Next, for the inner shadow, so in filters, shadow and glows, choose the drop shadows. Increase this live preview and choose the inner. As you can see, the shadow is inside the text. Increase the blur radius. It's too much. Change the horizontal and vertical offset. Hit apply, then close. Create a goal effect. So first, create a shape with Bezier tool. Press B and click. See this point and drag. And to here, click. And connect to the first point. Keep dragging. Press F2 if you want to edit the shape. Okay, let's put the gradient. So click this shape first, and with gradient tool click this icon, or the shortcut is G, and start to drag from the left to the right. So by default the gradient is in two colors. You can add more nodes while in this gradient mode, so double click. We'll create a new point to here, and I change the color to white. and on here, slightly to the left, and press D, change color to this color. Back in gradient mode, press G, and you see this plus icon, that means you can add the gradient. Double click and change the color same to this color. For this node, so double click and change the color to this color. And so here, double click and press D, change the color to this color. Okay, you can adjust it. Let's give some transparency for this node and here. So double click, right click, choose remove wheel. And on here too, double click. And on the fill, right click, choose remove fill. Let's remove the strokes, so by clicking the shape. On here, right click, choose remove stroke. Don't forget to send it to lower back, so click this icon, or you can press the shortcut, the back down on your keyboard to place it below this text. Feel free, you can still adjust it. And I just duplicate for the bottom, so press Ctrl D to duplicate and move it to the bottom, and press V, or you can click this icon to flip it vertically, and press H to flip horizontally, and you can edit it by pressing F2. If you want to edit the gradient, it's in here, or if you want to edit the shape with F2 and try to move. Oh yeah, by the way, you can still edit the text. If there's any change, you still can edit with filter apply on the text. Do it. Create a gold stroke with gradient for this ellipse, so click the ellipse. Alright, and choose the stroke pane on the fill and stroke tab, or the shortcut is Shift Ctrl F if you want to make the menu appear, and choose the stroke pane and change to this linear gradient. And you can change the gradient to last gradient that apply on your design, so choose this and change to this. And make the stroke style to pixel, and let's change to 20. Now you see this gold gradient, let's increase it more, 30. Nice. You can edit the gradient. Let's give this color for this part, so just double click and press D, change the color to this color. Same on here, so double click, press D, change the color to this color. I want to add some inner drop shadow for this ellipse, so click the ellipse and go to filters, choose shadow and glows, and choose the drop shadows. Turn on this left preview first to see what happened. And you can try to increase the blur radius. Want to add some registered trademark in here, press T, type R, scale it down, hold Ctrl Shift, change color to white, and with ellipse tool, create a circle, so hold Ctrl Shift and right click, choose remove fill and change the stroke to white. In the stroke style, you can reduce the stroke width to, let's try 5, still too much, 2. Okay, press F1, hold Ctrl Shift, scale it up, as it on here. reduce it by 1 or 1.5. I hope you enjoyed this video, how to create this typography logo. Please comment below if you have any question or what next we can create with Inkscape. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye bye.